We want to solve the given one-step equations. We first want to solve the equation x plus 2/5 equals 3/4. The solution is a value of x that satisfies the equation or makes the equation true. In order to solve the equation, we need to isolate x on one side of the equation. Notice right now we have x plus 2/5 on the left side. And therefore, in order to isolate x and solve, we need to undo the plus 2/5 by performing the opposite or inverse operation to both sides of the equation. Well, the opposite operation of plus 2/5 is minus 2/5, and therefore we subtract 2/5 on both sides of the equation. And now we simplify. On the left side, 2/5 minus 2/5 is 0, so the left side simplifies to x. We have x equals. On the right side, we have 3/4 minus 2/5. Because we need a common denominator in order to subtract fractions, let's work this out horizontally. So we have 3/4 minus 2/5. The least common denominator would be the least common multiple of 4 and 5, which would be 20. So let's write both fractions as equivalent fractions with a denominator of 20. So we'll multiply the numerator and denominator of 3/4 by 5, and the numerator and denominator of 2/5 by 4. Notice now we have 15/20 minus 8/20. And now we subtract, the denominator stays the same, and the numerator is going to be 15 minus 8, which equals 7. Which tells us 3/4 minus 2/5 is equal to 7/20, which is the solution to the equation. Which means, if we substitute 7/20 back into the original equation, it makes the equation true or satisfies the equation. And let's go ahead and show this for our check. Performing the substitution gives us 7/20 plus 2/5 equals 3/4. In order to find this sum, we need a common denominator, which would be 20. So we'll multiply the top and bottom of 2/5 by 4, which gives us 7/20 plus 8/20 equals 3/4. 7/20 plus 8/20 is 15/20. 15 and 20 share a common factor of 5. There are 3 fives in 15 and 4 fives in 20. So this simplifies to 3/4. 3/4 equals 3/4 is true, which verifies our solution is correct. Let's look at our second example. We want to solve the equation 2/3 equals x minus 1/2. Again, the solution is a value of x that satisfies the equation. In order to solve the equation, we isolate the variable on one side. Notice in this equation, on the right side, we have x minus 1/2, and therefore to isolate the variable, we need to undo this minus 1/2 by performing the opposite or inverse operation to both sides of the equation. Well, the opposite operation of minus 1/2 is plus 1/2, so we add 1/2 to both sides of the equation. And now we simplify both sides. Let's start on the right side. Minus 1/2 plus 1/2 would be 0, so the right side simplifies to x. We have x equals. On the left side, we have 2/3 plus 1/2. Let's work this out horizontally. So 2/3 plus 1/2. We need a common denominator. The least common denominator would be the least common multiple of 2 and 3, which is 6. So multiply the top and bottom of 2/3 by 2, the top and bottom of 1/2 by 3. Notice how this gives us 4/6 plus 3/6, which equals 7/6. So now we know the left side simplifies to 7/6, and therefore the solution is x equals 7/6. Of course, if we want to, we can change the order of this and write this as x equals 7/6. Either is acceptable. Let's go ahead and check our solution by substituting 7/6 for x in the original equation. Performing this substitution would give us 2/3 equals 7/6 minus 1/2. In order to find this difference, we need a common denominator. The least common denominator is 6. Let's multiply the top and bottom of 1/2 by 3. This will give us 2/3 equals 7/6 minus 3/6. So we have 2/3 equals 7/6 minus 3/6 is 4/6. 4 and 6 share a common factor of 2. There are 2 2's in 4 and 3 2's in 6. 4/6 simplifies to 2/3. And therefore we have 2/3 equals 2/3, which is true. Once again, verifying our solution is correct. I hope you found this helpful.